Hello and welcome to my weekly video blog. And today on A.Vogel Talks Menopause, this is week two of sleep problems during the perimenopause. So once you've got off to sleep, there you are thinking you're going to get a good night. And the next minute you wake up, your mind is going, you find that you can't get back to sleep, you're tossing and turning for ages. And very often when you get to sleep, half an hour later, the alarm goes off and you wake up feeling completely unrested. And we know that if you don't get a good night's sleep, as I mentioned last week, it can affect all different areas of your health, both physically and emotionally the next day. So I'm going to look at why there may be problems for you staying asleep and some nice easy tips to help you to remedy that. So estrogen is known to be connected to the metabolism of serotonin and other neurotransmitters that affect our sleep and control our sleep pattern. So if estrogen starts to really fluctuate in the perimenopause, this sort of control of these neurotransmitters gets completely disrupted. They don't work properly. They kick in at the wrong time. And that will cause you to either have a very shallow sleep, or you may find that you can wake up at the slightest little thing. And also these neurotransmitters are not around to help you to go back to sleep as well. It can be due to aging. And as we age, we tend to need less sleep. And very often we tend to go to bed later. We tend to wake up earlier. But obviously with all the physical and emotional issues going on in the menopause, we want to still try and get at least 7 to 8 hours good sleep every night. It can be night sweats. This is one of the biggest disruptors for sleep that just about every woman who experiences this tells me. You're having a sleep, you suddenly get a night sweat. You can wake up with palpitations at the same time. You're absolutely soaking, you're really hot. So you have to get up, you maybe have to change your nightwear. And by that time, your nervous system is all revved up. And of course, you can't get back to sleep again. So one of the things to do with this, if you're getting night sweats that are waking you up, you can look at the herb sage, either as a tablet with your evening meal or as a liquid, maybe about 30 minutes before you jump into bed. Have a small shot glass of water if you're getting night sweats, because even one night sweat will dehydrate you tremendously. That will affect your nervous system. It will affect brain function, and that can stop you getting off to sleep as well. So just a small shot glass of warm water, maybe 5-10 minutes before you get into bed. It can be the your blood sugar levels. And we know, and I've seen this so often, I talked last week about not having a big meal late in the evening, because that puts pressure on your digestive system, which will affect your sleep. But especially if you do have blood sugar control issues, then just a small snack, maybe about an hour and a half before bed, can often be really useful. And stabilizing your blood sugars can stop nighttime sweats, nighttime nightmares, and also just general disrupted sleep, and also the palpitations as well. That's very often to do with low blood sugar during the night. It can be bladder issues. So many women tell me they have to get up 2 or 3 times during the night to go to the toilet. It seems quite logical that if you're having to get up a lot during the night to go to the toilet, to not drink a lot before you go to bed. The problem here is that during the night, then if you're dehydrated, your urine is going to become very acidic. That is going to irritate the bladder, and that's going to wake you up and you will go. And a good indication of this is if you wake up desperate to go to the toilet, but when you get to the toilet, you only pass a small amount of urine. That's just bladder irritation. So again, make sure you drink loads of plain water during the day. In the evening, have an early evening drink, not coffee, not an irritating drink, but maybe a herb tea, something like that. And then again, that small shot glass of warm water before you get into bed can make a difference. I've had so many women say, you know, that's not going to help. I'm going to have to get up twice as much to go to the toilet. And they're so surprised when taking that extra little bit of water, they end up getting up less. So this can be a really helpful little remedy. If you're just waking up, if there's no other disruption, but you're just waking up for no apparent reason during the night, there's valerian and hops remedy, which you take about 30 minutes before bed. If it's more to do with anxiety, if your brain's going 20 to the dozen, if you're having really disrupting dreams, then you could look at night essence, which is one of the flower essences, and the flower essences work on emotional issues. It can be digestion. Now, we talked about digestion stopping you from getting to sleep, but falling estrogen can affect our digestion in many different ways. And one of the organs that can be struggling a bit is the liver. And this can be due to all sorts of different reasons. It can be just due to the physical changes that are going on. It can be due to hormonal disruption that's going on. But the liver, it's busy time of the day, if you like, when it's doing its most processing, is between 1 a.m. and 3 a.m. in the morning. So if you continually wake up at that point for no apparent reason, it may be that your liver is just working a little bit too hard. So in that case, you could look at a combination of herbs that help to support liver function, such as dandelion and artichoke. And we also have a lovely little liver support plan that if anybody's interested in, you can click into that for a couple of weeks. And again, it's amazing how many women tell me that they've done just a little bit of gentle liver work, and that's had a really beneficial effect on their sleep. It could also be restless legs. Again, this is so common, often due to low magnesium. And it's just the fact that low magnesium affects muscle function. And as you get into bed, your legs are doing their own little dance that you really can't control. Again, here, you can look at magnesium taken with your evening meal. There's also a remedy, it's called a tissue salt. And this is one that you just put under the tongue. It's called MagPhos. And that can be taken, again, just before you jump into bed. So again, what to do here if you're not sleeping well, if you are having a very shallow sleep, if you're waking up. Some people find it's just to do with noise. They're more sensitive to noise during the night, especially if you live in town or in a busy street. It could be the fact that their partner is just tossing and turning in bed, and that can end up waking them up too. So for these issues, again, herbs like valerian and hops can help to give you a little bit of a deeper sleep. And all the tips that I mentioned last week, like a good routine before bed, can be really helpful at helping you to stay asleep. And just remember, alcohol can help you get to sleep, but within about maybe 3 hours or so, because alcohol has such a sedating effect on the brain, this can often trigger stimulatory neurotransmitters that will keep you awake maybe for 2 to 3 hours. So alcohol is not really a good one for helping you to stay asleep during the night. So hopefully this has helped. Again, so many of you have such fabulous tips on things that help you. Please post them and share them, and we would love to see them. And until then, I'll see you next week for another edition of A.Vogel Talks Menopause.